Hi friends, in the last lecture we started discussing on arrangements in the topic probability in permutation combinations. Friends, let us continue this with a good concept called when the questions are asked in together case. For example, you can see little questions, some of the questions on when two boys sit together, all the boys should shoot together, one all girls should shoot together. In that, we'll be seeing that type of questions. So how to solve that questions in an easy manner, we'll be discussing. Friends, whenever you get these type of questions, remember one concept. These four steps are very important while you are solving these type of problems, friends. Now, initially, let us, what is the step one? Separate the groups. Friends, you just see how many groups are there. In the given question, you just see how many groups are there. Just now separate the groups. The first step is separate the group, and the second step is count number of groups. After separating groups, you just count how many number of groups are there. And step three is arrange within groups. We'll discuss it, what is arrange within groups, and at last the solution for this question is group arrangement into subgroup arrangements. Friends, we'll be seeing this step three and step four in the given question. Friends, I am having a question there. In how many ways can you arrange 5 boys and 3 girls such that, first question is, all boys sit together. All boys sit together. And second question is, of all girls sit together. Friends, see friends, what is the question they are asking? In how many ways can you arrange 5 boys and 3 girls such that all boys should sit together and all girls should sit together? Friends, previously we have solved questions on like that. For example, in previous we have studied it, G is left of A. G is left of A. So I'll be having G on left side and A on right side. No matter how many people are there between G and A, it doesn't matter for me. Let it may be 3 or 4 number of people, it doesn't matter that how many people are sitting in between G and A. But in this case, if A is the boy, B is the girl, all the boys should sit together. That is, A should be sit together. No two girls or three girls should not sit between a boy. So how can we do this type of questions? Friends, let's see that. First, what I told, the first step is separate the groups. How many groups are there? Boys are one group, girls are one group. So how many boys are there? Five boys are there. So B1, B2, B3, B4, B5. So let it, these 5 boys as one group. These five boys as one group. And let us assume that these 3 girls as one group. Right or not? So how many groups are there? We are having 2 groups. So we are having 2 groups. How many groups we are having? 2 groups. Friends, so we finished the first step, which is separating the groups. Next one is count number of groups. Friends, if there is some certain condition for step two, which is nothing but counting number of groups, friends, how it is means, see, what is the first question they are asking? All boys should sit together. So I am solving the first question, friends. I am solving first question, that is, all boys should sit together. Means, I am considering the whole boy group as one group. All boys group as one group. And every girl has one group. Every individual girl has one group. Every individual girl has one group. So, for the first question, how many number of groups are there? Total number of groups are 4. 4 number of groups are there. Right, friends? Total groups, how many groups? 4 number of groups. Friends, so these 4 groups can be arranged in a way that 4 factorial ways. How we can get these 4 factorial ways? For example, friends, what they are telling, all boys should shoot together. So what is the arrangement like that? I'll be having 5 boys in this place, and there is a combination of G1, G2, G3. I'll be having all boys here. I'm having a combination of G2, G1, G3. In this place, I can arrange 5 boys, and I'll be having combination of G1, G3, G2. So like that, I'm having different combinations. Out of this place, I am having how many number of boys? I am having 5 boys. So I can arrange in 5 factorial ways or not? So that all boys can sit together. B1, B2, B3, B4, B5 can sit together. Right or not? So what is the answer? 5 factorial into 4 factorial ways. 5 factorial into 4 factorial ways. In the same manner, how we can solve the question for all girls sit together. I am considering this as one group now. This as one group now. I am considering each boy as one group. That is one group. This boy 1 as one group. This boy 2 as one group. This boy 3 as one group. This boy 4 as one group. This boy 5 as one group. So total number of groups how much? So 5 plus 3. So total number of groups, how many groups are there? So sorry, this initially boys has 5 groups and this girl has 1 group. So how many groups are there? 5 plus 1, 6 groups. For second solution, there are 6 groups. So how can I arrange 6 factorial? Like that, what? B1, B2, B3, B4, B5. So I can place any 3 girls, I can place 3 girls here, G1, G2, G3. And again, a combination of B2, B3, B4, B5, B1. I can arrange 3 girls here. So G1, G2, G3. So that how what is the number of ways can I arrange here? 3 factorial. So the answer is 6 factorial into 3 factorial ways. Friends, I think you are getting the concept. Right, friends? I think you are getting the concept. If you are solving a question for all boys sit together, we should consider all boys as one group and each girl as an individual group. If you are solving a question for all girls sitting together, we should take girls as one group and each boy as individual group. Friends, I think you are getting the point. So we'll be moving to next question. Friends, I'm having a nice question that in how many ways can you arrange the word general such that all vowels are together. See friends, what is telling that all vowels should together, so that what are the vowels here? E, A, these are the vowels. Cut and orphans. So E are the vowels. So how can I arrange this? I'll be considering this as one group. So what are the remaining words? So remaining words which are different from vowels are consonants. So what are the consonants? G, N, R, L is are the components. So what is asking? All vowels should sit together, no? So that here in this previous case, all boys sitting together, I am taking the boys as one group. Here also, what is saying that all vowels are together, so that I should consider this as one group and the rest of the words and the rest of the consonants as remaining of one group. This is one group. Let it take N as one group, R as one group, L as one group. So how many groups here? 4 groups. What is the group here? 4 plus 1. Total groups, how many groups? 5 factorial. So 5 factorial. So out of 5 factorial, we'll be having these ones. How can I arrange these 3 factorial by 2 factorial? Na? Correct or not? Because total variables, how many? 3. But how many letters are repeating? 2 letters are repeating. So 2 factorial. So 5 factorial into 3 factorial by 2 factorial. So these are the number of ways such that I can arrange all vowels together in a word general. Okay friends, I think you get the concept. Together case, friends. So which is very important, friends. Now let us move to not together case. Friends, if you're having any doubt, please post your doubt so that I can improve my teaching. Thank you, friends. Now we'll be moving to not together case. What is not together case? Friends, we can see number of questions that such that no boy should shoot together, no girl should shoot together. So in that case, how can you do the answer in a easy manner in a short span of time? So friends, for this step one is arrange large group first. What is it, friends? Arrange large group first. So the large group should be arranged first. Think friends, large group should be arranged. What is step two? Count number of places in which smaller group comes. Friends, see if we see any question based on not together guess, these are the steps you should follow. What is the step one? Arrange large group first. They'll be having 2 groups or 3 groups or 4 groups in a given question. So out of these 4 groups, you should arrange the group first. Large group should be arranged first, and then count number of places in which smaller group comes. We'll be discussing this question, friends. Don't worry. So now let us take a question. I'm having a question that in how many ways can you arrange 5 boys and 3 girls such that no two girls are together. So what is the answer, friends? See, friends, how many boys? 5 boys. So B1, B2, B3, B4, B5. How many girls? 3 girls. G1, G2, G3. So out of these two groups, which is the larger group first? So this is the larger group. So I should arrange the larger group first. So friends, see, what is asking that no two girls should shoot together. For example, let me take a boy 1 here, boy 2 here, boy 3 here, boy 4 here, boy 5 here. So what is the question there? What can I see, friends? No two girls should sit together here. No two girls should sit together. So that I can place a girl here. 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 So that if two girls sit together, in between there is a boy, no? So that they cannot sit together. I'm correct or not, friends? So that how many places does 3 girls can get? This is 1 place, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So for 3 girls, there are 6 places to sit. So for 3 girls, there are 6 places. Let me give a clarity on this. Let me assume that I'm having 8 chairs now, because 5 boys and 3 girls. Now I'm having 8 chairs, out of which 5 chairs are occupied by boys. 5 chairs are occupied by boys. So I'm having 3 girls now. So 3 girls. For 3 girls, I'm having 3 chairs and 6 places. I'm back to orphans. So 6 places, 3 girls. How can I arrange 6 places, 3 girls? How can I arrange? I can arrange that already out of eight chairs, 5 chairs are filled up by 5 boys, so that they can arrange in 5 factorial ways. So how many chairs are they having? 1, 2, 3. So that the out of 3 girls, let me take G1, G2, G3. The girl 1 is having 6 chairs now. So 6. Now the girl G2 comes. The girl G2 comes, will be having 5 places now. 5. The girl G3 will be having how many places? 4 now. I'm right or not, friends? I'm right or not? Friends, I think you are getting the concept. So this is the answer, friends. Okay, friends. If there are 10 boys and 4 girls, what is the answer? 10 boys and 4 girls, what is the answer? You just pause the video and just see. There are 10 boys and 4 girls, what is the answer? So these 10 boys will be having in 10 factorial ways now. So what they'll be having? Rest of they're having 3 places. In that 3 places, so 11 into 10 into 9. The answer is 11 into 10 into 9. You just see this question and you just do this once, because it should be done by you. I'm giving a short way. Friends, I think you are getting the concept, friends. So this is the question based on not together. Guess how can you do it? So these are the very shortcut, friends, which you can apply everywhere. Now friends, I'll be having another question. In how many ways can you arrange word, which word will take? We'll take general itself, because we have already done a problem on this now, so that we can get such that no two vowels are together. No two vowels are together and do not come at extremes. So what is meant by extremes, friends? Extreme means which is nothing but the last, starting of the last and first of the last. So extremes are nothing but the the last places. Extremes are nothing but the last places. Friends, let me go through the solution. Friends, the word general consists of how many vowels, friends? It will be having three vowels. Right or not, friends? E, E, A. So these are the two vowels. So remaining all are consonants, which are nothing but G and R L are the consonants. So friends, I should arrange the word general in such a way that no two vowels should together. No two vowels should come together. So that I am having G, N, R, L. So I will be having, see friends. So I can place all vowels here so that no two vowels come together. But what is given in question, no two vowels are together and do not come at extremes. These cannot come at extremes. So these are the extremes now. What I told initially, the last places of a given word are the extremes. So that vowels should not be placed here. Right or no, friends? Vowels should not be placed here. So how many places does vowels are having? Vowels are having three places now. So three places, three vowels. Three vowels, three words. How can I arrange? Already these G N R L, G N R L are arranged in four factorial ways. So the word E is having, the word he is having three. The next word is having two. The next word is having four. Divided by two factorial. Because we are having a double E now. So that two factorials. So friends, this is the answer. Two factorial nation, but how many number of alphabets are identical? Okay friends, I think you are getting the point. Next is one of the important question which is based on alternative, friends. So friends, we'll go through this by question, friends. Arrange five boys and four girls such that boys and girls sit alternatively. Friends, I think you know the alternate, what is meant by alternative, so that one after another, friends. So how many number of boys, friends? Five boys, four girls. So what is telling that alternative, no? So let me take a girl here, let me take a boy here, let me take a girl, let me take a boy, let me take a girl, let me take a boy, let me take a girl, boy, girl, boy, girl. Right now, friends, so that a girl can sit here, a girl can sit here, a girl can sit here, or it may be four girls now, so that a girl can sit here, girl can sit here, girl can sit here, or it may they can sit in this place, in this place, in this place. So they are sitting alternately now. So initially five boys can sit in a five factorial ways. Correct or not, friends? So initially five boys can sit in a five factorial ways. But let me give one conclusion that the exact meaning of alternatively what it means, friends, so that no boys and girls should sit together, so I'll eliminate first and last places. Right or no, friends? I'll eliminate first and last places. Why I'll be eliminating first and last places? So that no two, what is meant by alternatively? Alternatively means no two boys should sit together. So in this case you can see that no two boys are sitting together, no two girls are sitting together, because in between the two girls one boy is having, I'm correct or not, friends? So that I should remove last two places. Why should I should remove last places? For example, let me take a friend's with a girl, a boy, a girl, a boy, a girl, a boy, a girl, a boy, a girl, a boy. See friends, if I make to sit a girl here, for example, five boys now, if a girl is sitting here now, so that these two girls are sitting together now. Correct or not, friends? If I'm taking like this, so that two girls are sitting together now, so that I should remove the last two places, because in this case we are getting that the girls are sitting together. What is meant by alternately? So that such that no two boys and no two girls should sit together. No two boys and no two girls should sit together. So that I should remove these two conditions. That what is the condition I'm having then? So removing these three places, now I'm having boy, girl, boy, girl, boy, girl, boy, girl, boy. So initially five boys are arranged in five factorial. Now how many girls are there? Four girls are there. How many places are there? Four places are there. Now so five factorial into four factorial. Okay friends. 5 factors into 4 factors. This is the answer, friends. You just once go through the lecture. Friends, for this I am having one easy trick, which is very easy trick. That is, friends, see, whenever you see the question alternatively, compulsory there should be difference be 1. See, friends, 5 boys and 4 girls, now what is the difference? 1. If you see the question alternatively, compulsory there should be difference only 1. If more than 1 is there, we cannot arrange them alternatively. Then what is the answer? Boys factorial into girls factorial. What is the answer I got? 5 factorial into 4 factorial. 5 is nothing but number of boys. What is 4 factorial? 4 is nothing but number of girls. So boys factorial into girls factorial. Friends, I think you got the concept and you understood this. So together case, now together case, we have seen in previous lecture based on arrangement. So how can we arrange? I think you got the concept. Thank you, friends. We'll be discussing the further classes in the next coming lecture videos. Thank you.